gonna be a eventful video. I'm gonna start a lot of, let me go ahead and say, today's video is gonna start a lot of controversy. Why do I feel like I didn't say that right? But
it's time.
Time for what, you might ask. It is time for the Outlander to finally shit on the Polaris.
Now, I'm gonna try to stay unbiased as possible in this video. I love the Outlander, so I don't know how this is gonna go. Miller, what are we doing?
We're doing Outlander versus Polaris video. It's finally happening. Let's do it. Oh my god.
In today's video, we're gonna be talking about the difference between the Outlander and the Polaris.
I'm gonna try to keep this as unbiased as possible, but I know from riding this thing for a couple weeks now that I've had it and I've broken it and I've had it and stuff has popped out. I know all of its flaws, kind of, sort of. And I know all the Outlander's flaws. There's a lot of reasons why I would not have the Polaris. So what we're gonna do first, we're gonna go over the physical stuff. We'll do the cons of the Outlander, the cons of the Polaris. We're gonna be here a while. The pros of the Polaris and the pros of the Outlander. So let's start off with pros. Do the Outlander pros first. So if you look at the dash on the Can-Am, you have huge, nice display. You can toggle through your DPS, which is your power steering. So all I'd have to do is hold this button right here, and then I can toggle. Now it's on minimum, so the power steering's not all that there for high speed stuff. You can hit it again, and I can change it to medium, and then I can change it to max. I like to leave it on max because I do a lot of slow riding. And when I say this is the best power steering I've ever felt, it is so buttery smooth and so crispy. The power steering, huge plus. The throttle, this has an electric throttle. It is so touchy, so responsive in sport mode. It is so crisp. Oh my gosh, do I love it. Now to go along with that crisp throttle, if you don't want to have it so crisp to where you feel like if you accidentally hit the throttle, it's gonna jump out from under you, you can use this button right here and toggle from sport mode. That sport mode off, toggle over eco mode. The eco mode, you can feel the eco mode. I thought I broke this thing when it was in eco mode.
I remember that video.
Somehow I got it out of sport mode and it was in eco mode. And I was like, what is going on? I done thought I blew something up. Put it back in this. Now you got eco off as well. So that'd probably be normal mode. What else we got? And then we're gonna put it back in sport so I don't forget. So nice big display, all these buttons and toggle switches. They're all fire. I love them. So if you come over here to the shifter, it's just a straight line. So it's just low, high, neutral, reverse, park. It's so easy to find gears on this thing.
Yeah.
Because it falls into these notches.
Yeah, the notches.
So it just falls into whatever gear you want it to be in. For the belt box, you have it right here. You can change a belt on the trails in 5 minutes, hands down. If you got your tools ready, 5 minutes, take it all apart, new belt. Very easy to work on. When I first got this thing, I was coming off a Honda and I was looking at this thing. I'm like, this thing's like a spaceship to work on. But then after I started, you know, working on it myself and figuring it out, it's actually pretty simple. Obviously, if I sink it, I'm not gonna be able to rebuild the motor. It's dual heads and I'm not about all that. But another great thing, Cody has a Renegade 1000 2020.
Yeah, 2020.
Yeah. He has sunk it 3 times and you don't even know it.
Yeah, you can't.
As long, if you sink it, don't start it up. Just take it to the house, start changing your oils, changing your fluids, back to back to back. His has been flawless. I could sink this thing, no doubt, and be perfectly fine, I know. Gotta get snorkel risers though.
Gotta order them today.
I also love that it comes with the big bumpers. These bumpers really help protect you. So you got this nice bumper in the rear. We like to play bumper cars, yep. A lot of fun. If you look at my front bumper, it shows the damage because normally I'm doing the pushing.
Oof,
I'm doing the rear ending, boys.
Oh. Oh, Jesus.
So the biggest three things that I love about the Outlander, the smooth, buttery, crispy power because of that electric throttle, it being easy to work on if we're talking about compared to the Polaris, and the power steering, it is great. Now, if we go over to the Polaris strength, let's see here. One of the biggest things that I do like about the Polaris that is kind of a good thing, but a bad thing is your radiator is actually
kind of shielded.
You don't get any mud in your radiator when mud's getting thrown up everywhere. If your fans go out, it's gonna overheat. No doubt about it, if your fans go out, it's gonna overheat. There's no airflow other than the fan. But, you know, you keep the mud out of it. So, you know, it's kind of a win-lose, but as long as your fans are running, great design. Polaris, they have some soft seats. I don't have any problem with my Outlander seat, but if you feel the seats, the Polaris seat definitely takes the W. This thing's got more ground clearance than the old Outlander. I do like the factory snorkel setup better on the Polaris, the Sportsman, because all the snorkels are right here, all the same height, whereas on the Outlander, you have a snorkel here, here, and here, and they're all kind of spreaded apart, and I don't like that. I'd rather them all be tight and in the same place. There's got to be more that I like about this thing, or I'm going to seem very biased. Sounds good once you put an exhaust on it.
All right.
Yeah. That is it for pros for the Polaris. Seat, ground clearance, snorkels. But I think the Outlander had the same ground clearance if it had the same size tires.
Yeah.
Not 100% sure there, but. We're gonna do the cons on the Polaris. So bear with me, this is gonna take a minute, boys. Cons for the Polaris. The belt box is in the absolute worst position ever. The belt box is all the way back there. Your drain plug is all the way down here for the belt box. To change a belt, you have to take off this tire. I don't know what else all you gotta take off, change a belt, but I know this tire has to come off, and that should just be a never mind, you know, what is that? It should be on the side, but it's not. Also, I said I like the snorkels. I like their location, I don't like them. I hear from my experiences already, I have gone over this entire snorkel system, and I think the factory seals around the actual belt box are leaking. I've heard people have problems with Polaris shipping warped boxes on four-wheelers where they just take on water, even if it's the high lifter model. So far, the airbox snorkel has been good that I know of. It hasn't sunk yet, so that's good. Also, if you compare the Outlander to the Polaris, both 850s, both mud edition. There's no bumpers, no winches, no nothing. But where Polaris makes up for that is the price. I didn't get the best deal on mine. I paid $12,400 for my Outlander. This thing, my buddy paid $8,400 for. So you gotta look at price, but the way I look at it, if you're taking payments out on something, get what you want the first time, you can always extend your payments. Like you can do 6 years on four-wheelers.
Yeah.
So you know, you can get your payments down and get what you want the first time. More cons. So take these plastics off, you have to have a T40. Kind of a pain in the ass to unscrew a bolt, take off your side plastics, especially when it comes down to washing this thing. Another huge con is brake pads. These brake pads suck. The Polaris pads suck. My buddies, they said they went through so many brake pads. So many. When they said they had a 5 gallon bucket full of old brake pads.
Oh my God.
Stupid. Wheel bearings.
Oh.
You gotta love the wheel bearings. Both wheel bearings are shot. Another buddy, same four-wheeler. He lives over there at Busco. He says he's put 6 wheel bearings in every single wheel. Every single one. The four-wheeler is like a 2019 or 2020, I think.
Yeah.
Wheel bearings, brake pads, starters. The starters are garbage. Diego, he's went through a starter, and two of my other buddies with Polaris have both went through starters. The throttle, stupid laggy. I hate it. Terrible. Awful. Terrible. No power steering. Sucks ass. If you're making payments, get what you want the first time. It likes to cut off. It's a 2019, and look at this display.
Ooh.
Crispy. The shifter, dude. I almost forgot. So the shifter, there's high. There's slow, there's neutral, reverse, park. It is so hard. If I want to go from park to low, it is so hard to find. And then when you're in low and you want to, there's low. And then when you're in low and you want to go to reverse, you always slam into park. I hate it, dude. I absolutely despise it. Oh yeah, diffs like to explode.
Oh.
This spoiler's had 2 rear diffs. I think it's had an axle. We're gonna move away from the Polaris. I'm tired of talking about it. The Outlander, cons. This radiator. If you're actually sending it like you're supposed to, it likes to be filled up with mud because you're spinning and throwing mud everywhere. The mud scrapers in the wheels, they will blow up your diff and they will blow up your wheel. Personal experience, Can-Am warranted it. It's great. If I buy another one, the mud scrapers are coming out.
This drive shaft right here.
Oh yeah.
I've seen a couple of them explode. I would say they need to just beef it up just the slightest and then it'd be solid. I don't really have any more cons, dude.
Yeah, I know. This thing's pretty like flawless.
Oh, the key.
Oh,
the key likes
the key
to fall off. Do not kick your key off. I've kicked my key off once or twice.
Just get a
tree took it off. I kicked it off. Lost the key twice in a mud hole. Not fun. You gotta have a floaty, which got ripped off.
Yeah.
By the tree that ripped off the key. Yes, sir. I told my, like, if this four-wheeler were to explode tomorrow, I would buy another one. All right, so I feel like I have done enough talking. We're going to go ahead and go ride. We're going to hook them up, have a pull-off. No clue who's going to win that. Maybe that'll show four-wheel drive. Mm-hmm. I don't think it'll actually show who has the better four-wheel drive. I think I don't know who would win.
Yeah, I don't know. It'd be a good test.
The Polaris feels heavier, but they're honestly about the same weight. Got a race.
Yeah.
This thing's getting walked.
Oh, for sure.
All day. The Outlander's got it. They both got tunes. They both got exhaust. Equal playing field here. So yeah, let's slap a GoPro on and get after it, because we got to do a little bit of testing. It's not the most scientific testing, but who doesn't like racing and stuff? Whoosha!
Oh yeah?
Oh yeah?
What?
What?
That was loud! Oh my god!
Alright, time to get these machines warmed up and then we can race. Oh, I'm in four-wheel drive. Oh, I changed.
Brayden, I'm on a plane.
You're on a plane, right? So we do got some talking we gotta do today. Gonna bring it back to good old moto vlog style, boys. Yes, sir.
Whoa, you put turn signals on this thing? That's crazy, bro.
Let's get this thing started off with a wheelie. Oh, let me warm her up first.
What the hell?
Just T-boned the hell out of him. Get this old bad girl warmed up.
It feels like these wheels about to fall off though.
I also say the brakes on this thing are better. All right, let's get this started off with a hand drag.
Mr. Wheelie Man's gotta get his wheelies in.
You wanna see me hand drag it?
Oh, oh. Hand drag first try? What?
Yes, sir. Got the hand drag the first try, baby. I got the hand drag first try.
First try.
I've been trying to do a hand drag forever, dude.
Oh my god. Yes, sir. Oh
yes,
my
god. I got it, baby. Woohoo!
Oh
yes,
my god,
sir.
One-handers?
Oh,
oh my gosh, did you see this? What?
I'm so happy to wheelie this thing, dude.
Bro!
Let's go!
Let's go!
See what Miller's got on the Polaris.
All right, here we go.
Put it in low.
Okay.
So there ain't no excuses. Oh, yeah!
Woo!
There we go! I couldn't get back up. I couldn't go to standing on the seat. 1v1 mud competition.
Next video, 30,000 likes.
Next video for 30K likes?
Yep.
I'm gonna push you all over that swamp, boy.
Let's do it.
Oh, no! Hey! Now, I do want to, like, stop talking junk about Polaris, mainly because I think sponsors don't like that, but I ain't a sellout, boys. If I were to stop talking junk, it's for the fans. See you, Miller. Let's go! Let's go, buddy!
Oh, scooter in it.
Yes, sir. The throttle's so smooth. I love that, dude. Hey, you want to race? Huh?
Yeah, let's go.
You want to race, bro?
Yeah.
Yeah? Let's turn down. This power steering's so great. I'm going to turn it down to medium. That way, yeah, you can literally feel the power steering change. It's clear as day. Line up on this crack before I crack you upside the head, boy. All right, I'll let you start.
All right. On your mark, get set, go!
Not even a race. Not even. All right, one more time. Right. 1, 2, 3. We're at 60. 70.
Oh my god.
All right, I gotta slow down. This thing's a little sketch, not gonna lie. How fast did you get up to?
It tops out at 48.
What?
It tops out at 48.
It does not top out at 48.
I press the gas, go, na.
You're in low, dumbass.
High. I'm in high.
Give me that thing. What? It's supposed to top out at like 58, but it's got a tune on it that should take that off. Let's see. 30. 40. 50. I don't get that, dude. There's my mama. Where are you going? I wanted to race. 30, 40, 50. He's right, it does top out at 48. And it's showing it's in high. What the heck? Why is this thing governor? What? Wow, the steering on this thing.
Dang, you were running good.
That set down on this thing I do not like. This thing is a lot different to wheelie.
This thing's way too easy to wheelie. What the heck?
It takes a lot more practice to wheelie this thing. That thing, you can just hop on it and go. I want my foiler back.
Nah, I don't want to switch back.
Give it back.
No.
Give it back. Miller.
Man.
Ride a wheelie with me.
Can I do one wheelie?
Yeah. Damn.
I want one.
You want one?
Dude, this thing rides so much better.
I know. You brung that wheel up like it wasn't crap. Ride with me and do a hand rub.
Do what?
Hop on and do a hand scrape.
Oh my God. Okay.
You holding on there, old son?
Do I hold on to you?
You can hold on to me.
Okay.
Just ain't no homo. You got socks on, right?
Yeah, I got socks on. Ah! Oh my God.
You holding on? You holding
okay,
on?
Alright, alright, alright.
What?
Oh God, oh God! Ah! Oh God! Jesus! Oh God! Oh my God!
You get the hand scrape?
Yeah, I got the hand scrape. Yeah.
Yes, sir, let's go. Alright, we gotta do a pull off. Find a strap, find a strap, find a strap, strap, strap. See if the Defender's got a strap in it. Hello, sexy. How you doing? There's a strap. That strap ain't gonna break.
I hear the turbo spooling down.
I've had the strap since I bought the Polaris Razor.
Yeah, it's a race quad. Yeah, it doesn't have like racks or anything in the front or like a bumper because it's so aerodynamic. You know, it kind of runs up over El Brapo right there. So freaking fast, man. I almost had him in the race. If it didn't top out, it'd probably beat him. Shifter is actually designed after a Lamborghini tractor. So, you know, you just need to pull back to put it in park and stuff.
Oh, he's about to get pulled. He does have bigger and meatier tires, which helps his case. And the ground's wet. What do you mean lose?
I mean, this thing's just so fast. I mean, so much power.
All right, lights out, sunshine. He's got the better side, I think. I'm kind of pulling uphill a little bit. We'll have to do it on the concrete.
I don't want to do that.
Let him pull me back a couple inches. Lock the brakes. Send it. Nope.
Okay, whenever I get traction again, I need to hit it. Okay, let him. Come on, buddy.
Come on.
What?
Could go. Let him think he's got it. Lock it up, get a new position. Oh, he can't stop me, huh?
I'm not losing this. I'll... Oh, no!
Let's throw it on the concrete real quick.
Wait, no, wait, I'm not ready.
What? I had to cut off.
No, 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 no,
no, no. Oh, it's cool. He's got his brakes locked up. Oh my gosh, like it's nothing. All right, back to the yard, you lost. Did you lose? Yeah? Okay, put me back to the yard. I have to say, you lost bad.
Yeah.
For some reason, I had more faith in the Polaris than the Tug Off, but you lost bad.
You want to do an off-road race?
An off-road race? I mean, you'll lose.
Probably.
I waxed you on the road.
Yeah, oh yeah.
You ready? I lied. It was not close.
All right, one more, one more.
One more?
That was sick!
You, hey, you start on the concrete. I apparently didn't have much problem putting traction to the ground because it wanted to come up into a wheelie.
Hey, do you know of any windows I could go and lick real quick?
Windows? Oh, to lick windows?
Yeah.
You got your truck windows.
Oh, that's, can I lick your house windows though?
Yeah, if you want to. All
right, cool.
Just make sure you Windex them after.
Yeah, they probably taste better anyway.
Yeah. All right, you ready? I'm gonna throw this on the pavement this time.
I'm gonna try low.
All right, try low. I'm gonna put her back in four-wheel drive then so it's equal. Yeah. Oh, dude. Oh, dude. Sad.
Woo! Yes, sir.
Oh, is my gas light on because I was in a wheelie? Or is it on because it's actually low? We'll find out here in a second. I don't like that throttle control though, baby. All right. Oh, got it. Got the hand scraped down.
Yes, sir.
I'm about out of gas, dude. I gotta save this for later tonight. Where'd Miller go? I hope you guys are enjoying this style of video. I'm sure this video is long as hell. We're running two GoPros. We talked so much in the beginning about the different foilers and stuff instead of just coming out here and having fun like we're used to.
What is he doing?
He can't be trying to hide from me because that's a terrible hiding spot. Ow. Hey, I'm about out of gas.
Eat my berries.
We're about out of gas, so yeah. It looks like it's the end of the video.
Does it have to be?
Yeah, it has to be.
But I'm having so much fun.
On that?
I don't want to edit.
I absolutely railed you today.
Okay, stop. You gotta stop saying things like that, like you did to Kyle in that last video, okay?
Bye! Meet me at the house, Mila. Well, boys, I'd say it's been a fun day. Actually, seeing the Polaris run, I have rode with that a couple Polaris 850s, and everything that I thought was kind of proven, other than the tug of war. Tug of war to me is very, I don't know, could go either ways, but we won it, so that's what mattered. But the race, I just had a feeling this thing was going to wax the Polaris. And Miller's lighter than me as well. So it was actually in the Polaris' benefit to win. But every good video's got to come to an end. So let's finish it off with a hand drag. Woo! There we go. Like, subscribe, leave a comment. Tell me what you think about all this down in the comments. Did you like this video? Did you enjoy it? I would love some feedback from you guys. Like, subscribe, and I will catch y'all on the next one.
Dragon, yep. Brandon's gonna be like, hey guys, catch you in the next one. Peace out, keep moving forward.